destruction happens, he cannot say exactly. But then from the past stories, it seems that the ruins was happened because of the river. So okay, when there was a flood, and then maybe there was no proper maintenance after that. Okay. So maybe the water, river water just...
Okay, now that's an interesting part which you have mentioned, the maintenance part. Yeah. Now from the side of the village, is there anything like a, you know, a step that was taken to restore this place or to do something about it? Can you please answer?
Emi mak kejing perkat yang pegang bercenang wa kamon u cenabi yang ini kejung ini kamon u le.
Oh iten ay dekat tep tep ni plan bahai tapi cemlat ika kamon u le. Untuk skim dekat kerajaan kamon u le. Ina perkat hadu kan ni leman untuk lat yang we cem ka terus em kamon u le u yak u rapi u bahai pemet cucu ini wa debu em. Penek nong rimis eh.
Lemie dia penyen lek kamon.
Lemie lek tahu.
Penek tak ini u tahu pera cucu ini.
Itu asal kuat itu awam semtau kau ilek, ibar yang ilek kamu kata jodoh ini sih tidak ada.
So one thing my Ben is trying to tell us is the thing is, see the people here they are interested. He as orang Bashno also, and moreover he's from the indigenous beliefs. You know he still believes in that thing.
The local religion.
The local yeah. Okay. So what he's trying to say is that he wants to keep this monument. More for the future generation to see and to know what is happening.
Good.
So, but he said that because of the, I mean, they have no means. They don't know whom to approach.
I see.
Or maybe whether the government has any kind of development activities which they can approach to, and then maybe they can help to develop this, or maybe to at least to protect it. It can be kept as a heritage site, kind of things like.
No,
this is what they wish from the...
Yeah, in fact, like, these are of great historical importance, especially when we talk about the Jayantiyas, to reflect more on the glory of the Jayantiya Raj during that time. And I strongly feel that this should be declared as a heritage site, you know, where if at all, if we cannot do much about it, but at least like whatever that's there, the ruins which are there, it should be protected in such a way where there should not be any more damage, you know, that's being created to it. So, of course, it's very difficult really to fight against nature. Mm-hmm. The flooding will definitely take place. But if at all, like whatever that's there, if you can just maintain it.
If you look at the ruins here, from this foundation to the other one. Mm. So
there's another foundation, is it?
Yeah. You just think, I mean, how big the house
the expanse,
I mean,
no?
The expanse of the house.
It's pretty big. So from to that point, is it? Can we just go to the side?
Yes.
Marvin, can we just... All these stones are just part of the building, and here, right ahead of us here, we have a pillar. And according to what the local people have to say here, that even this pillar was carried out by the flood water. It was moved out, rather it's being toppled here, and so much so that if you can tell from this side also. We can see these are all pillars of that one big
the
structure.
The hole in the middle means put a lock.
Now here we can see that there are holes right in the middle, and on both sides there are holes. Perhaps these are being used, you know, as a kind of a lock system. Is it? Now one thing which is very interesting to see here, that these are all stones which you can get from the riverbed. They're round pebbles, big and small. One interesting character is like how they managed to put these stones. How they managed to put the stone. But for information, like the kind of a bonding agent has been used here. That's something which we cannot really speculate at this point of time. But there's no doubt whatsoever that this place is full of limestone. This place is full of limestone. So therefore, like perhaps, and other kind of a bonding agent.
Which one?
Which one?
it cannot be a clear ka lot by the pillar type.
Ni kejuk ni watai dah. Dia lah sang. Bukan ni watai kram.
Kerak dong.
Ha, yuk ni hek ni ni tre dong. Tak ada kena ni. Kalau tak ada itu ko.
Now one look into this. It does appear, looking at the size of the hole here, it does appear to be a kind of a chimney, and there is a kind of a connection between this hole from here and the other part of that structure from the other side. But as I've said, these are all, and we can't really substantiate anything as yet. Well, perhaps the archaeologists or the other experts who are comfortable in this field, they'll be able to throw more light on this. But as for us, this in itself is a great thing. See and note here that how in this place where the king's palace stood at one point of time, today we have the betelnut trees all around, including the banyan tree. And this is again a clear indication that nothing is being done really to restore this place. From the look of it, it does appear again that perhaps even the local people, maybe out of poverty or other reasons, unknown really, perhaps like they don't know whom to approach and things like that, this place is not all maintained. But we do strongly hope that this will create some kind of an awareness where the authorities concerned would try to look into the matter and maybe try and do something about this place, which is of great historical importance, especially when we talk about the life of the Jaintia people. Now we are very fortunate really, with the help of the local people here, with the headmen around, we are really taking advantage of the situation. We are here on the Tisang River, it's known by that name here, Paramuntidu. And this is the river where the king used to come with his people. And it's a beautiful experience, rather like none of us are really good in swimming, so we are holding tight to the boat.
I mean, deep cut.
It finds a potential for tourism also here, you know, by the look of it.
Yeah, it should be.
Not only that, this place has a historical importance, the kind of scenic beauty which is there. And if you can have a look towards the side, look at the greens around, the evergreens. It's well spread, the huge limestone rock there. It's just amazing. And looking at the scenic beauty and the kind of things,
trees,
which the place has to offer, no wonder why the Jaintia King have decided to take this part of the place as one of his site, you know, like to break his journey. Okay, I would like to ask one question, if you can just ask Ma Bin about it. Now, do we have visitors coming from, you know, from other places? Like maybe from Shillong or from Joy or from other areas? Like, do we have people coming to this place?
Ma Bin? Haka chis nam jam ki pu 1 1 1 5 ki ki ka ahi
nela ban na yero
ban sam de ban sam ban ki ki so de sam po da
okay ki ki picnic chini 1 game
ha ki da ok le bon boy kon ki chini
de Sulong.
Is there any provision? Is there any provision like you know for people to stay, for people to stay and all that? Is there any provision?
Tourist ini udah Muslim nyawa, kerapau nyawa ni sih wangi, bulu keren, wangi sah setia wangi. Menajun mau itu?
And they do come, is it?
Yeah, as way back as 1987, mm-hmm. people from I mean the foreign tourists they came here.
Okay.
How many of them are on work? Two of them. Serang okay. Banyak. Two of them, two gentlemen from. We don't know from which country, but then they are from outside of India.
Okay.
So they came here during 87, and they stayed here about a week.
I see. So there's a place to stay also? There's a accommodation facilities?
I haven't heard of Okay, there's no such place where you can just come here and stay, just like a hotel or something like that.
Okay.
So they have made an arrangement in the school building.
Oh, itself. Okay, in the school premises itself?
Yeah, school premises.
Okay.
Maafin ya, untuk amperti kemerik gini gimana?
Ini niumu he ini mau tajar nongi. Dekten berkat nongi semau terangcar.
Semau
terangcar.
Okey ila.
Mana tajar gitu rim he ini.
Kejar tong dekah.
Kejar tong dekah. Tadi ni tu orang ini penuh ini berarti. Ini aku kini.
Bon.
Ila. Kumu nongi sih.
Ila.
Kumu kini nongi. Tapi tip ini mu.
Can you explain that what he was trying to tell us?
Yeah. What Marvin is trying to tell us, see, you can see here there are three stones.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, one is the big one and it is very rough.
Yes.
The other one is the very round one and quite smooth.
Okay.
And this smaller one over here.
Yeah.
So this bigger one here, the big one is rough and it's, this is called Mao Thatja.
Dry up their nets.
In English means where they are drying the nets. No?
The fish nets.
Stones,
the
fish nets. Stones where the fish net is being dried.
Okay.
After fishing, catching the fish and then I think after resting and all, they put the net here and then they dry it.
Okay.
And the second one which is very quite polished and
okay.
The round one, rounded one. This one they call it the Mao Mokbi, which means what do you call it?
Earthquake.
Earthquake. Earthquake stone. A stone at play, I don't know it. So we have another one, another big one.
See,
you can see just like a piece of iceberg, you know, they're just like. Yeah. So the other one to the other side, that's the first one we've seen.
Mm.
It is called Smear Rinchong.
Smear Rinchong.
That is in local dialect. Smear Rinchong.
See how we round the roots.
This is nice, like the way we're moving. Right through the thing, yeah? The stone, is it? That's beautiful, it's amazing, yeah?
So you can see how